Please welcome to the stage Professor Dr. Eka J. Wahjoepramono.
First, thank you very much for inviting me to be here. Dr. Rajiv Peshawaria, Michael, Sabri. I don't know why I'm invited here, because I'm not leader, I'm not boss. But I just want to show you that some important organ, if something damaged, don't think about leader. Everything gone with the wind. I show you the proof. I show you the proof. Okay, so when Rajiv asked me what is the title, I do not know because I don't have theory about leadership. So I'm not going to talk about theory how to become a leader, but I just want to share my experience and what my understanding after exploring the brain. So, you know, title is Brain and Its Function. It influences human being and leadership and pioneering in my field and brain surgery. So again, without brain, everything gone. I'll show you later. So brain, you know that this is actually a central cable. Central computer. So brain made of water, and from the brain come everything. I will show you later, yeah? Because of the brain, so you are here. Somebody with no leg like a Geneva can come here, but no brain is definitely absolutely. So you will never be here without brain. No leader, no chairman. So I agree absolutely with Sajiv said that about clarity of purpose, clarity of value, and also ability to use the hardness of the brain. But actually, from which side? From which side? So brain, not only our soul, but only our mind is there. So if you say that, oh, I'm very, very disappeared as a disappointing or something. Everything is in the brain. I'll show you later. And so talking about energy also, again, so many theories. Maybe someone become a leader because of the genetically. So maybe the family of Aquino, family of Kennedy of the U.S., family of Gandhi becoming son, becoming grandchildren, becoming leader. But there are something that we cannot create genetically. But something that what Rajiv doing is how to make like nurtures from the environment, how to build a talent to be a leader, right? Something we can do. Genetically, we cannot do anything. Genetically, we cannot do. So again, question where actually the energy come. I agree. So like a Mandela was 28 years in the prison, and why the energy is still there, right? Sometimes I'm thinking about probably Mandela living in a very hard situation, but million people like Mandela, why only him? And still have energy in the prison 28 years. And somebody maybe quit and give up and follow something, but Mandela is not, right? So this is a big mystery. So ladies and gentlemen, learning brain is more difficult than learning outer space. Much more mystery we still do not know. So we just know some very few, but something we do not know is still mystery. But let's explore with me. So you know, this is brain. And the most front here is maybe related with intelligence. Look at the I'm sorry, Mr. Ajiv's forehead. Why he became so smart? I will show you the other example, right? So I mean, from here, then become Mandela, become Gandhi, and become Mother Teresa with a golden heart, becoming the Pope, and remember, also becoming terrorist attacking Paris. So they are also leader. Can you imagine? Sometimes I'm surprised that somebody, can Pak Budi's friend, yeah, and can hijack Airbus or what? Struck the twin tower of the Black September in America. My question: how come their leader can wash the brain and become striking the airplane to the twin tower? How can be? I don't think that Mr. Sajid can praise you and wash even to go to the wheel or go to the sea, but they can struck and then go suicide by himself. How can? It's very difficult to understand, right? But they are leader, and we need to learn from them how they can be a leader, can wash the brain from somebody. That's only happened in the era of a couple hundred years ago in the Chinese era, where somebody opened the hat and make something, the people that totally dedicate whatever to the king, to the emperor. But it's not anymore right now. Something happened, we need to learn about how to become a good terrorist. So because of the brain. Hippocrates, this is the father of the doctor in all of the world. So already a couple centuries before Christ already said, and men should know from nothing else but from the brain come joy, delight, laughter, yet sorrow, everything. So you can be very sad, you can be very happy. You I think somebody asked, why make you happy, right? Your brain. Believe me, without brain, you will never happy. Several people ask, right? From happiness come from the brain. Believe me. Well, so we all together go to the market and eating, maybe with the people and drinking coffee. Somebody unhappy. Oh, why so low? Why Sajid don't bring me to big restaurant? But somebody said happy. Oh, happy. I enjoy drink with the people in the market, in the Vietnam noodle, whatever. Your brain make us happy or sad. Really. So be careful. It's not our environment, yeah? Our brain. Really. I will show you later. So, you know, from the brain, so this is, you know, the brain is process of chemical electric. This is the chemical electric, make a stimulation between cells in the brain. And again, from here, you know, there is an electric process in the brain. So I'm talking, there is an electric process in my brain, in my speech center. Make them can enjoy like this, they can kiss, and sometimes very sad, and even going to suicide. Somebody, for instance, two girls, one is left by the boyfriend and still happy, oh, I'll find another boyfriend. But the other suicide. Right? And what's happening? It's because their brain. Because their brain may be a production of some so-called chemical electric less in somebody. Make it very easy to get sad. This is a patient came to me. He got a very severe traffic injury. We did surgery on the brain, and we can save him. But you know, many part of the so-called neocortex, I'll explain to you later, are broken and damaged permanently. And he become like a plant. So he live if somebody give food. So he can swallow, he can cry, he can heart beating, but no terror communication with outer space. So he don't know everyone and even himself. So he become a plant. So you believe me now that without brain, it's like this. And this is proof. It's no question, no doubt. Everything is in your brain. This is proof. And this is so-called a vegetative state. And after one year, we call it vegetative state permanently. So forever becoming like this. I was invited, a very rich person in Jakarta. The only son struck by truck and becoming like this. Dr. Eka, if we can make him alive, I give you how much ever you want. So I said, no, I'm sorry. Up to this second, the rule is one of the neuron, the cell of the brain, died is never and ever recovered. Up to this second. So be careful about your brain cells. Really. Okay, so again, this is the brain. So you know the brain, and this is consists of cells. You know, this is cell, the cell of the brain, you know, this is like a stars, with so many hair like this, right? So everybody got about 100 billion cells since we born, everybody. And you know, the cell is never increased in number, never and ever. But you know, the cell of the brain, so you know there's many hair and the hair connected each other, so-called a synapse, you know? So sorry, this lecture. So, you know, synapse, the more we learn something, and especially if we learn something very impressed, for instance, we saw Geneva here, it's so impressed. That is different if we only read the book of Geneva, but showing the video, it'd be so impressed. Impressed beings come to the brain and come to the permanent storage of the brains. Then, for instance, you are a teacher. Then you can encourage your student, oh, I saw Geneva. It is impressed in my mind. And maybe also encourage ourselves to be like that. So means that what you saw when Geneva here, so you saw and it coming to here. It's not coming to your brain cell, means only temporary memory and will be gone when you come back to your country tomorrow, you forget about Geneva. But if you impress very much, so that's why I always, when I give talk, I always use so many movies, I just want to give you more impressed, I hope. Then you never forget about that. So anyway, brain, we divide it into, this is the old brain, so the Archie cortex, and this is new brain. So the red layer is new brain. So everybody, this is old brain, this animal also have. So your sexual desire is here, your appetite is here, your angry center is here, your patience center is here, so-called the Archie cortex, amygdala. And then after becoming more modern, so this old brain covered by the new brain, so-called the neocortex. Neocortex is where make different you and I, and make different why make man to be a modern in development of human being. I'll show you that. Because of the so-called the neocortex. So be careful if you broken neocortex. Both must be balanced, right? In Chinese old philosophy, they said the yin and yang, means this must be balanced. You can imagine very smart, but you have no desire. If you have no appetite, you can imagine. But if you have appetite too much, you don't bring, we this also very careful. For instance, this one, this looks very wild, right? A lion, a cheetah, and then hunting deer and eating, like looks so wild. Why? Because they have like this, when they feel angry, they want to eat. He doesn't care. The deer is coming from where, he just want to eat. This is animal. But we have also the same, but we different. Because before you eat, of course, you have to order first, you have to pay first. Right? If you always eat everything like this, policeman will catch you. So if we teach a young generation, oh, you want to be, we have a sexual life, you have to be married first. Better. So animal also has a, like a desire. But in such can, if I saw in the mall a beautiful girl, I want her, or maybe somebody would help me. So again, our brain is balanced between the old function, Archie cortex, and neocortex. Be careful, make balance. Make balance. You cannot add some cells, I told you, right? But you may add your synapse. The more you learn, definitely you're more smarter. Because something additional in the synapse. So this is the brain function, old and new build, brain. So you know that the brain actually is just like a human development, evolution, mostly in the frontal. I told you, right? You see here, the more here is the more forehead. Please touch your forehead. How big it is. That's true. So I don't want to make any discrimination, but you can see that some ending is so flat, and you can imagine what's happening with them. It's yes or no? Please ask me. Yeah. Okay. So actually, this is like evolution of human brain. This is the devolution. Yeah. So we remember that 100 years ago. So The first erected human when I give talk in Ethiopia, so I visited a museum, they have a so-called Lucy. Lucy is the first erected human. Before that, they walk like this, right? So you know that from Africa, they go everywhere becoming developed, and Australia, America, and then Asia becoming developed. This one developed. So the old brain is not developed, same, but this one developed. So in Africa, they don't mind, they just kill each other and eat. But here it's different, right? So because of the developing of the new cortex here. So here, again, the developing of them. And you can see that after that, one of the first civilization in the Middle East, they can build a pyramid. And mummy, maybe founded, maybe, I don't know, 7-8 years before Christ, 1,000 years before Christ, they already have a chain, right? They have a necklace, everything. Even maybe my ancients still walking like this around the river. So this is all of just a human civilization. But again, leadership is not only making modern, but also sometimes makes some people terrorist, I told you, like this. So becoming very bad. And you can see here, sometimes this is the colony of Dutch at the time in Indonesia, 300 years ago. And then there's becoming terrorist bombing, everything. So because of your brain, sometimes becoming a positive side, becoming a good leader, but something becoming all this negative side like this, all just because of the brain. They are all leaders, but which leader we want? So this is, again, this is developing of the brain. This is Nazi, for instance. Hitler is a very good brain, a very good leader. But what kind of leader he is, right? So actually, I'm not expert of the brain. I just learned from my exploration of the brain. So start from 1997, I start in my hospital. At that time, my boss want to build actually like a modern hospital for heart surgery. But I think, why heart surgery? I said to my boss, let's go to the head brain surgery. He did not trust me. Okay, I give case, and finally he has to buy something to develop my brain surgery. So by opening like this, we know that everything is in the brain. So right, not only the case I showed you, but here you can see after opening the brain, you see here a center. This is, for instance, like a nerve for your eye. This is a tumor, yeah? Nerve of your eye here. If I do wrong, I remove, for instance, the patient becoming blind after surgery, for instance. So from this exploration, I know exactly. For instance, somebody got stroke. When we remove the stroke, the hematoma from somebody, I don't know why my patient always laugh. To meet everything, just laugh. It's different personality before. Somebody very sad, always stay at the room, sometimes had to suicide. So again, everything is in the brain, believe it or not. Everything is the brain. Be careful, yeah? So if you come to me, be careful which one you want to touch, to be touched. can make you different. One of uncle of my colleague, so he got a severe injury. So finally, he can save him. You remember, after he saved, he talked, so he got like a so-called frontal lobe syndrome. Frontal lobe means that he can talk everything honestly without break. You have break, right? So, sorry, when he talked in ICU with the wife, it's already date 30. Please remember, yeah? Send my money. This is my second wife is dead. My third wife is dead. And then the first wife become collapsed. he talked everything very honest. That's very honest. Just because no break. So before that, he talked everything, of course, with break, right? With this something. So be careful if you have a brain disease. Remember your break. So that's true story. I'm not kidding. Okay, so this is about brain surgery. Now developing very much in my country. So before I start in 1997, it was only traditional brain surgery in my country. So I introduced modern brain surgery from 1997. It was everything is just trauma case, but we developing everything now. Okay, so this is from learning my experience. So Somebody told me, Eka, you have to build a team. It's just impossible. You work everything yourself. It's impossible. Too dangerous for the patient. And I believe, then I built a team. Now working with me is 19 neurosurgeons working with me, handling Siloam Hospital along Indonesia. Because again, nobody can work with himself, especially the very dangerous and risky surgery like this. If you come to neurosurgeon, don't trust if your doctor only work alone. Sometimes he's tired, he said something, he's quarreling with a wife at home, then coming still like this, want to do surgery. Better with the team, yeah? Believe me. So, my hospital here, 1997, then we now developing a system in Indonesia where this is my team, 19 of them. I put them in the whole Indonesia. And they need always report to me with using WhatsApp, BlackBerry, whatever, every case. So even this is the south pass, the east pass of Indonesia, the patient come to him, I guarantee that every diagnostic and every option therapy is standard. Standard means whatever they upload, real-time upload, we can get advice in a team, right? And our system is my young colleague working here in Kupang near Pak Budi's place. When they have a difficult case, I said, don't do surgery yourself. Wait, tomorrow I or my team will fly there and working together. So this is what I create in Indonesia. You know, Indonesia have 17,000 islands. Managing Indonesia, I said, it's much more difficult than managing United States. how can you touch people here? People here also live at 2,000 in the village. You walk 10 hours, 10,000, 10 hours. How can you manage? So I try to develop something different that may not suitable at different with a developed country because geographically it's like this, right? With the 250 million inhabitants, with 1,300 ethnics, blah, blah, blah. So this is Indonesia, what we are created. So after we starting like this, then fortunately, then people becoming trust us. So patient coming from not only from in whole Indonesia, but from overseas also come to our center to repair the brain. And, you know, they come to my place, maybe with aeroplane, with helicopter, but sometimes with this is like so-called angkut. Angkut is just a traditional public transport where there is no facilities. So in a brain surgery, I said and I promised also on my team, because Indonesia at the time, even now, the health insurance is still very bad system. So many poor people also come to us. But I say, I have knowledge, I have skill, and somebody may be dying or suffering, need help, nothing, something to be removed from the brain. I said, there is no reason for me not to do because they cannot pay. So our team, for instance, we promise we will do free, definitely free. But who will pay for the expenses? So that's why later I will tell you about how we built a so-called Indonesia Brain Foundation. Because it's unfair if somebody need our help, we can help, but nothing can be done because of the money. So this is what we are doing in a group. So actually, my personal experience, what make me like this, when I was young as a son, inspired me just because my mother working very hard. Every day, every morning, I saw her working very hard. She never talked something with me, but I saw her working very hard, and I had to wake up in the morning, I help her, I help my brother and sister, I take care of them. And also, I saw one of my neighbor is a good doctor. So it just in my mind, there's a so-called a memorizing. Inside, maybe it's good if I could be a doctor. Now the question is how to reach. Only willingness cannot be done, but how to reach that? That is the question. So, you know, what is memory? It's a process of retaining, storing, recording experiences closely associated with learning and also through knowledge. So I told you before that maybe somebody become little because of genetically, but somebody maybe because of the environment input. So that's what Iclif made, right? So given the environment, something to do. Genetically, we cannot do anything, right? So environmentally, for instance, through visual, then you see the movie, then coming to your so-called temporary memory. So if your movie has not impressed you, so tomorrow you forget. If the movie impressed you a lot, like you saw Geneva here, you saw by yourself, no lag. So if the temporary memory becoming impressed, then becoming so-called a permanent memory. So why something maybe somebody told me when I was child, and I never forget until I died, for instance. Why also another talk, but it's just like this. And also from visual on haptic. So this got a memory. So teachers need to learn how to make the memory becoming a permanent store. Right? So that's why there's so many methods of teaching, for instance, by everything, just to make the permanent store of the memory. Right? So this is about environment. So from the eye, you saw something. This is the cable, so-called optic nerve, then going to the brain and again going to the short-term store. Then when going to the long-term store, need a technique. That's why we develop technique, how to make participant interested. Right? That is from the visual. Also from learning. You learn something beautiful, and you impress, you go to the short-term, then if very much impressed, go to the long-term store. So some sentence, some words sometimes, again, I never forget until I died what my mother said to me. Only a couple sentence, what my teacher said to me, until I died, I never, because in the permanent store. Right, this is so-called just short-term store. So active learning need everything. As we say that, if only read 20%, 30% hear, see, 50% say do, and 90% see, hear, say, and do. That's why we make it like that in a leadership training. So that's when I was in my childhood. Then fortunately, after struggling a lot, I accepted the medical school. In medical school, when I have a conference of surgeons, I saw surgeons coming from whole Indonesia to my place. Oh, I said, oh, how great they are. So handsome, so big, so rich, blah, blah, blah. So that impressed me. So, oh, I want to be surgeon. So that's impressed me a lot, seeing them in the conference. And again, how to reach? So again, only impresses cannot, nothing happen. But how to reach that? How to become like that? So this is when I was in medical student. Then, again, fortunately, after struggling, so in Indonesia, in that time, so many discrimination about some, you know, we have so many ethnics, religion, blah, blah, blah. So there is a lot of discrimination. So the people like me is highly, highly unlikely to be accepted to learn in the so-called specialist program. And I want to be a neurosurgeon is just like a dream. But something happened that I met a very good professor, accepted me to be his pupil. Then I got chance to learn so-called neurosurgery residency training program. So my professor, I had a lot of impression of them. So he brought me, he introduced me to International Society, his friend. So I met so many great neurosurgeons along the world. So I was so impressed. So I said, oh, I want to be like him. So again, this is also many actually doctor like me. But somebody, oh, I won't do it. Maybe this is just enough. Oh, I cannot do it. So it's so difficult. But how can make you the energy, make us to be, okay, I will do it. I will do it. So that is, I don't know what's inspired me, but I want to do it. So I told you that at the time Indonesia was very much underdeveloped in brain surgery. So I just thinking, why I cannot? So my boss gave me chance to learn in Germany and also to practice in Japan. I just thinking, why Indonesian doctor cannot do like that? What is the difference? I mean, we have the same brain, we have some forehead. And also equipment, yes, I will ask my boss to equip me to do something. Then finally, I need to prove that Indonesia is not less that developed country in brain surgery. So with what I'm thinking at the time. So again, impression is very important in the beginning. So that's why I bring my student, my son, my daughter. When I have a great meeting conference, I do, oh, you see, this is the big man from Harvard. This is the big professor from Japan. Please take care of him. You talk, you chat, you inspire others. This is my purpose. So again, now knowledge we can learn by ourselves. Students, is very easy to get internet to learn. Knowledge is very important. But again, now most important for us to be teaching is to be a role model. Role model. So when I started my career as a neurosurgeon, I want to do my best for my patient. What does my best mean? My best means that somebody comes to me, then I have to find out what is the final diagnosis. Must be not wrong. Then I have to give an option what could be done. So, and the patient, okay, doctor, I want to get surgery from you. Then I have to do surgery not less than developed country. This is what I mean with my best. So when I started in 1997, yes, of course, I was still young and very, very less experienced. Fortunately, when I was in Japan, I have so many friends. They are so nice. So many senior colleagues. Oika, don't worry, I come to you. They came to my place. They pay everything by themselves. I just treat them to bring somewhere and having food. But when they come to my place, then they teach us how to do surgery, us and my nurses and everything. And then one of the patients from Fujita, I still remember, after 3 years, he told me, Eka, it's enough. We came here 3 years working with you, doing so many surgery. It's enough. Do not seek any help. Do not beg any support again from other country. You have to do yourself. It's enough. He said to me, I remember, never forget in my life. And he said, now, Eka, your time to go to other countries to help them, to support them. That's why I was committed, and I still committed to be like an educational committee, we call it, in the World Federation. So every month I fly to go everywhere in all continents, Bangladesh, India, United States, Germany, to share what's happening with us, and to share the knowledge and the skill to them. That is my commitment. So even I go to Ethiopia, you know, we are 12 faculty go to Ethiopia because Ethiopia, there is, they cannot rent this beautiful building like this. So the meeting was in the United Nations building. So we came 8 o'clock in the morning, no student come. So faculty have to wait 2 hours, then they come one by one. Okay, we start. That is Ethiopia. So anyway, this is our commitment. So after a certain of time, we enough to fulfill that we have to share with other. This is what I doing. I said what I do my best for my patients. So for me now, at that time, again, many patients, just very easy to cross Singapore, Malaysia, Australia, Germany, if they have money, America, to seek the brain surgery. Because of what? Because we were so bad. We were so unprofessional. So patient didn't like us. So they prefer doctor abroad. So we cannot forbid them to go. So I said to my colleagues, what are we doing? Do our best, prove that we are not less, then they will trust us, right? So we cannot forbid them to go. Anyway, we do everything now, my best to my patient. So I said to my patient, I will not send you abroad wherever because we are unable. If you want, of course, if you have money, of course, but we will not send you to other center because we are not able. So, I mean, whatever your case, I will able to do it. Me, my team, and I will able to do it with the same and equal quality with developed country. In brain surgery, quality means the same number of mortality and morbidity. Mortality means if I do 1,000 surgery, 2 or 3 died is normal. If I do 1,100 diet, it's not normal. Nobody come to me. So this got a mortality. So I mean mortality and morbidity must be equal or not less. So at that time, actually, after meeting a lot of great person in the world, so I said, oh, I want to be professor. I want to be professor of neurosurgeon. But how? I told you at that time there are so many discrimination. Don't dream that because like me will be accepted or will be proposed as a provisor. Okay, so after I applied in the government hospital in Bandung area, but I rejected, okay, go, we don't need you. So anyway, I work in the hospital, just normal hospital, it's not teaching hospital. After 2 years working, then somebody, why my energy is almost gone? So I don't know, a senior professor re-energized me. Eka, why don't we again coming to your idea to be professor? Oh yeah, I remember. Because the only institution could propose me as a professor, university. So I proposed to my university, why don't we open a medical school? At that time, we had no medical school. Actually, so I come to my boss, I encourage him, boss, maybe good if we have a medical school. Oh, yes, you're right. Then we go together. I cannot do it because need money, right? Then my boss and I go until finally we can open medical school, so-called the UPH. So after a couple of years, I said, okay, UPH have to propose me as a provisor. So what do you call it? It's like mutual network, each other. I need him and he need me. Right? I said, oh, boss, I need you, but you need me also. Right? So this is working together. So that's why now I became professor because my university proposed me. And I created to build a university. So this is a mutual something that is working together, right? So I don't know whether it's correct or a mutual harness. So I want to be respected to other universities. I told you I do many cases. Then I show, fortunately, when I presented my surgery, I will show you later. Then I invited to give talk in Harvard, in Toronto, whatever. I just want to show the world that our standard is equal, not less than them. Because in surgery, different, yeah? Surgery, surgeon like me is not only can talk, yeah? Before I show a lecture like this, I have to show where is the imaging before surgery, and how is the surgery, and where is the imaging after surgery. So we cannot cheat. And again, people like me, I have to talk in front of them based on my own experience. So I cannot talk, oh, this is Japan experience, this is Malaysian experience. No. What is your experience? Then they can believe and they can talk. This is a medical provisor. So you should not talk based on other person's experience. Have to come from your own experience. Then you have to be listened about it. So this is, I want to be respected and show the word about it. So this is one of the case, milestone important, I never focus in my life. In 2001, came to me a young, old, 21-year-old male. He is a poor people. He has no father and mother. He immediately got paralyzed. And the eyes like this, and the breath almost stopped. And he brought by his brother to my hospital. When we check like this, this is the so-called MRI. You see, have you seen MRI before? If you not yet, you come to me, I bring your MRI. Sorry, this is not promotion, but it's very important to see your brain. Don't laugh. And that time, everybody after 40, you said, oh, I want to go to a heart checkup. Everybody, right? I said, more important, brain checkup. Why not? Once you have money, you can do brain checkup without any harm at all. And you can see your brain, how big and how good your brain. Actually, tonight I will show you, if you can come all together, how to take care of your brain. And how to check your brain. Very easy, very cheap, and very accurate. And because this is so-called MRI is never wrong. For instance, doctor, my wife still every day headache, I don't know. Okay, just go MRI. I don't want to discuss a lot. Do MRI, the brain could, oh, she has a headache because of you. Except there is a tumor inside, I can remove the tumor, but it's normal brain. So because of you, probably, you need to give a diamond, whatever, then headache gone. So anyway, you see, this patient, this is MRI. And this is the brain. The brain is center, everything, you understand, right? center everything of your body. So the brain control your body. So the brain is not like a cells and becoming fiber. Actually, that's a bundle of cables. The cable coming to intercentral cable, so-called this is like a brainstem. Brainstem as big as your thumb. Located in the center of here. This is the center of the brain. If brainstem damaged totally, doctor, can you say to you, you are brain dead. Brain dead means you dead. Even your heart still beating. And this is in Europe what's happening when your heart's still beating and you brain dead. This is a time for them to remove your heart, your kidney, your cornea to be transplanted to other. Because you died already. This is so-called brain. So you know how important brainstem. So at the time, he immediately paralyzed because of the tumor here. You see this tumor as big as a meatball. And the tumor ruptured. So immediately, he was dying when he came to me. When I saw this, I said, oh my God. I said, frankly, doctor, I have to be frank to the brother. I have never seen before a living brainstem. I just saw in a cadaver, in a dead body practicum. I never seen before. Even in Germany, in Japan, I never seen. Don't talk about operate. Even never see before. But I said, but your brother is in a critical condition. If you ask me to refer, I don't know where to refer. Because I don't know, I don't listen who in South Asia operated this case. And if I send to America, maybe we don't have time. And who will pay? They are very poor people. And brother told me, Eka, I trust you. Do something to my brother. Tomorrow, my parent left me a very poor house in the beach. I will sell tomorrow. I don't care how much it cost, and I will give to you. That's brother said to me. Then, oh my God, I said, well, okay, I need to, because this is the first time I got one assistant. Okay, anyway, we have to explore. And I come to my boss. My boss is a banker. Boss, look, this is very important. Please pay. Oh, really? So, I mean, I have to use also my boss' wealth, right? But he is a great man. Eka, don't worry, go ahead. I said, this is a very important case, boss, and somebody dying in front of in your hospital. Because he did not expect that the poor people come to the hospital. No, for me, no, boss. Poor or rich people may come and make the same service. So anyway, we operate and we remove this tumor. This is a very, very tough, most difficult, dangerous, rare case. And we did the surgery. So the patient is in the prone position. You see from here, operation. So this is the beauty of brainstem. You understand, ladies and gentlemen? So I need to open the brainstem. So can you see how my heartbeat was? So I have to remove this just like a delivering a baby. And even this type is one of the very, very unique and difficult case. Even in the US, it's never happened like this because that picture is very beautiful. This is a tumor, and this is like a round, you remember, right? They got so hollow sign, like if in a Christmas card, you say like Joseph, we say like this, is a hollow, yeah? So I said to even young generation, oh, Merry Christmas, it is horrible surgery. And even I said, oh, I don't know, he died all of it. But anyway, fortunately, you know, this is after surgery. He is a fisherman. He's still alive. Thank you so much. And he visited me every year bringing corn, bringing fish. Yeah. And this is, so I told you that surgeon, if show something, I need to show the MRI after surgery. Right, the tumor was here, right? You remember? And now it's gone. So it's not to be seen, but I'm like, oh, okay. I understand Indonesia can do it. Before that, there's nobody believe. If you only talk, nobody believe, right? So that's okay, I believe. And this is also re-energized me. So, you know, sometimes the doctor will be so tired. You know, if in a month there is 10 patients with a stroke, especially a stroke in the left side, anybody of you left-handed or not? Anybody of you left-handed? So if you're left-handed, please write down here, yeah? Oh, I'm left-handed. You know what I mean? Because if we do surgery, if the tumor located at the center, we always prefer go to the right side. Because if we are right-handed, so left is dominant brain. If possible, we go not through the dominant brain. For instance, somebody gets stroke, I will tell you tonight. Stroke in the right brain means paralyzed in the left extremities, right? Only paralyzed. It's okay, you can walk. But if the stroke is in the left brain, which is dominant brain, you get paralyzed in the left side and cannot understand everything, cannot talk everything, difficult, and what you said, I accept different, I talk different. Very frustrated. Very, 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 because this is dominant brain. So please write down in here with tattoos that I am left, right-handed. If surgeon don't know and open your left brain, be careful. Really, so that's about brain. Brain is a miracle, right? So left and right is different function. Be careful if you are right-handed, be careful with your left brain. Yeah, talk to you, doctor. Oh, I'm left-handed. Yeah, doctor, be careful. Don't operate to my right side. Okay, anyway, he can come back like this, and this is a milestone. And everything is well documented. So when I presenting in the lecture in Bali, many colleagues from America, they was okay, and Eka, please come to Harvard and talk a story about this. Then also, of course, this is like a milestone for us. And this is re-energized me. Sometimes we are so tired. I told you, right, in a month we have 10 patients with stroke. After surgery, like, you saw stroke patient or not? Have you seen severe stroke, so-called? If the stroke in the left brain, long life. The more they taken, the longer they live. You need to talk to your spouse. If I cataract this, go for surgery or not? How about you, Yajib? So, in the U.S., they said, for instance, okay, call to the lawyer and also to the spouse. If I got a severe stroke, don't bring me to hospital, yeah? Because I saw every day. So for me, it's very exhausted. So sometimes it's terrible, terrible, terrible things, right? This is, be careful, yeah? So check your brain, say to your spouse, if you get severe, go ahead or not. So again, this has re-energized me to do more difficult cases. So from there, we initiated to have so-called like a brain foundation. Up to now, maybe we have about 300 cases of brain. Not many, because the brain surgery is very costly. So we cannot, fundraising also not that easy. So, well, becoming doctor needs empathy, sharing, loving, caring. It's not only knowledge, not only skill, but everything have to be in the same side of the brain. So after that, I was invited to give talk in Harvard, in Massachusetts, in almost whole Asian country. And also, I give talk, somebody, my role model, invite me to get everywhere, almost every month now I give a talk in abroad, just talking about brain surgery. Because that is the first time, but you know that it's not always incidentally. After that, because we did everything, then about 50 cases of brain surgery came to us. And we can, not difficult, but not so difficult, and still easy to do that. And everybody, no one died within 50 cases. It's quite prestigious, just because of him, right? Maybe without him, we still doubtful whether we can do it or not. We can do it. But after that, there's no problem. You can come to me, we can operate for the brainstem surgery. And this is quite a lot. When I give talk in Oxford, in Oxford is one of the oldest medical school in the UK, about 400 year maybe. He said that they do it within 400 years. And we do it within 20 years. This is not the case, for instance. So-called giant aneurysm. Giant aneurysm is like a balloon of a vessel which is exploded. If this is mild exploded, make you headache. If you don't check, the second explosion will coming. So this is one of the most difficult case. I have never seen before also in Indonesia. I have never touched before. But you know, I promoted through the television newspaper about how dangerous so-called this is aneurysm. About aneurysm, if you are something, please come to the doctor. Oh my God, someday come a real come to me, the pig like this. I said already this is dangerous, need emergency surgery, but oh, I never do it. So I said also, well, anyway, I said to my team, we have to do it. So you know that sometimes we push to do it because of the situation. So this is need something that really what you would be a bit crazy. Because before that, nobody want to do in Indonesia. It's too difficult, too complicated, too risky. And the cost is same with you to the head injury patient. Head injury patient come to me, maybe died, maybe left, no problem. But this one, she came only with headache. You can imagine, once I make a mistake, for instance, the bomb exploded during the surgery, she may die on the table, right? And this type of surgery, once I started to do, I have to find it. This is not easy to find, yeah? So there is no reason not to find. Once I found it, I need to do and to kill the bomb. If I cannot kill because of some reason, so the patient even still danger and more danger before surgery. So this is a very, very, very big moral obligation for us. Okay, fortunately, God is always in my side. So we can do it here, surgery. This is the aneurysm. This is brain surgery here, yeah? Using microscope, enlarged about 20 times. This is the bomb I told you, the socket here. And we can finally so-called clip the bomb. So the bomb is killed by clipping here, like this, like this, like this. And this is one of the first we done in Indonesia, I think about 2004, something like that. And this is also like a milestone that we now believe that we can do everything ourselves. So you saw this is all clipping of the aneurysm. So this is clipping aneurysm. So this is, she is a lady, come from Bali and flew to my place with a headache. So this is like moral obligation to do the best of the patient. So like this. You see, this is after surgery, no more bomb, and this is the patient. We always show like this. This is the patient after surgery, so not a cheated. So this is another also so-called a bypass surgery. You know, before that, people know only bypass in the heart, but actually a brain also could be bypassed. So you need to check your brain and your vessel. Don't laugh me. Sometimes you don't know that the vessel is very... It's very common you check your heart vessel, right? When it's narrow, then it's going to standing, right? It's very common. But brain, be careful. The brain, you need to check because of the brain is narrow very much. Sometimes we need to bypass. So I said to my patient, when we are old, oh, I prefer to die because of heart disease rather than brain disease. Heart disease, oh, I can die peacefully on my bed in my room. Don't bring me to ICU. But because of the brain, if you brought to ICU, oh my God, you may die, you may survive, you may half die, you may three quarters die, you may one fourth die. I don't want. So I said like a vegetative like this, right? Oh, I said, oh my God. Every visitor said, oh, so sorry about that, so sorry about that. And then finally died. So again, yeah, remember when we are old, we don't need to go to heart checkup, just brain checkup. You agree with me or not? So if you don't agree, you come to my place, I bring you to ICU tour to see. We have a collection of the people like this. I'm a doctor, I said, I don't want to be like that. So better, if I old enough, I died on my bed, on my room. Don't bring to ICU, it's horrible. So yeah, everything. Because of your heart, your brain, yeah? So this is brain vessel surgery. Okay, then after that, I invited again really that I give talk in the whole continent and the world. Every month, I share my experience. I like education very much. So we help the young generation to come. Even we have to pay for them to come to the center. And unfortunately, my center now is appointed by the World Federation. So every young neurosurgeon can come to us and we will provide everything to learn 3, 4, 6 months. So when I was appointed as a dean, what made me agree to be dean? To be dean for me is actually a disadvantage. So becoming dean, surgery, I can earn $1,000 per hour. But as a dean, my payment is only $2,000 per month. So I said that, okay, I still was have some idealism that I want my student, my young colleagues, maybe better than me. So I said to my student every time in the first year of the lecture, I invite student and the parent. I said, look, I said, we doing everything in 20 years in brain surgery, and then our position is not less than other country. If you guys, you want to be like a heart doctor, kidney doctor, intestine doctor, with a principle like this, that you don't want to be less than other, and believe me that you can do it. I believe that Indonesia is not less. There's nobody look down. I believe. This is what I said to my young student. That's why, again, I'm not expert when my boss appointed me as a dean. Oh, I don't have a talent. I don't know about medical education. But what I do is just like a role model. And what I do, okay, boss, but give me a chance, yeah? I invite my colleague from Canada and from India to be my vice dean to rule everything. I don't understand. So I just be like a role model for them. So I want to encourage them to better career and future role model. And I say to them, it's very good. From nothing become something. So before I started 1990, it's nothing. Nothing modern neurosurgery Indonesia become something. Something that we can show the world that we are not less. So I always compare like this. Okay, Mayo Clinic can do it, I can do it. John Hopkins, I can do it. With the same, with equal result at the end. This is what I said to my student. So last, it's how to re-energize, I told you. So meeting patient, I told you, sometimes re-energize me. So meeting the guys who bring me fish every year, re-energize me. Sometimes I'm so tired, oh, I don't want to do it. So I got once very bad experience in my life. I got a 40 years old man with two diseases in the brain. One is the balloon-like so-called aneurysm, and one so-called AVM. Both is very, very, very difficult. So I need to do twice surgery. I did one surgery, so-called aneurysm, the balloon. The balloon located is the most difficult place. Everybody in the world knows it's the most difficult. And I killed the balloon successfully. Then the patient, okay, you come back home about 2 weeks, then for the next surgery. And then I spent with my family a New Year holiday in New Zealand. I remember about that. So, you know, patient of mine, after they come back home, they're becoming my friend. We text each other. At that time, no BlackBerry. Hey, how are you, doctor? I'm fine. I'm happy in New Zealand with my kids. Oh, we are also happy. We're just having satay in somewhere in the restaurant. But doctor, don't forget to remember to come back to Indonesia. Yeah, I remember my second hat. Anyway, I let my wife and my kid spend more time in the Gold Coast, and I came back for him, what I promised. So I came back, I think, almost in the end of the year, and we did the second surgery. Second surgery also difficult and very long, 11 hours. So, you know, you can imagine, I removed the disease, and I was closing the scalp. When I closing the scalp, the anesthetist told me, Eka, stop. The heart stopped beating of the patient. Huh? You kidding? So invite you, your colleague, come here. Check. Maybe your cable is not connected. Really? How can you imagine? So coming 2, 3, another anesthetist told me, Eka, yes. The heart stopped. So patient died on the table. Behind my hand. And you know, at the time, we have operating theater here, and this is a glass wall. And sometimes, you know, I let the family observe the surgery. And the wife sitting beyond the glass wall, sitting and watching what I'm doing. Can you imagine? Oh my God, Afid, maybe I don't want to talk anything. How can I talk? I just say, assistant, you close the eye. I don't have no more energy for me. So we just cried with her. And going home, okay, so you know, eating also, so I don't know what I eat. And my family listened to go, really, there's about 3 days, really no energy. It's really bad. You know how bad my feeling. It's not my fault. But again, how bad my feeling. So you know what re-energized me? The wife texts me in a cell phone. Hey, Kang, how are you? We just came back from the grave of my husband. Because the 3 days, this ceremony 3 days after died, yeah? We just came back. He said, Eka, I'm the one who lost someone who I only have. They have no children. So you can understand what I'm feeling, Eka. But the next sec, he said to me, but Eka, go back to your hospital. Go back to your job. Go back to your patient. I know you are very frustrated, but go back. That is what she said. That is the only thing, the only text really, really make me alive again. This is a true story. This is a very hard job, but again, that's re-energized me. Okay, I come back again. I kept with a challenging, so that's really happened with me, and I have never forget all my life like this. So you can remember, the wife who lost her husband re-energized me to come back again to my dangerous job. So if I'm with patients, sometimes they re-energize me. And also if some of your students also re-energize me, okay, sometimes I go outbound with them because I know this is a very young student, they need a role model to reach the better future. So this make me re-energize. I don't know how to say in a theory, but something re-energized me. So you need to also what re-energized you. Of course, it's different, right? But this is really my experience that re-energized my career. So last, keep balance, working tireless, and enjoying life. I like also not really diving, just snorkeling. I like animals, I like plants. Sometimes just, this is to refresh, yeah? Not to re-energize, but to refresh. But re-energize is different. In my opinion, it's different, right? Remembering us that, our job's still far beyond, that we have to go straight. I thank you very much for your attention.